from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of a country's diversity. Let's begin the show with the Gira waterfall of Gujarat, which is endowed with implausible natural beauty. Known as the Cherrapunchi of Gujarat, this waterfall is one of the most picturesque sites in the state and is frequented by a number of tourists every day.
Situated in a verdant setting near Satpura Hill Station, Gira waterfall is a beautiful seasonal cascade in Dang district of Gujarat. Also known as the Niagara of the state, the waterfall is formed after it emerges from Kapri tributary and falls from 75 feet high cliff, dropping into Ambika River. The speed of water plunging into the river creates a foggy look, giving a charming feel. Gradually, the waterfall is developing into a popular picnic spot that attracts a number of tourists who are looking for a respite from their daily life. At present, one can find a lot of rush at the place as people who were restricted to their homes for a prolonged period of time are now flocking to areas set amidst lush greenery.
लॉकडाउन के बाद पहली बार है सो काफी भीड़ भी है इधर और बहुत सारे लोग इधर विजिट करने बहुत ही सुंदर वातावरण है और सबको ये पसंद आएगा।
दो साल से सब लोग घर में ऐसे ही बैठे रहेंगे तो अभी एक साथ छुट्टी मिल गया तो थोड़ा सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग का तो दिक्कत रहता ही है, थोड़ा सब सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग भूल जाते हैं पर सही से कर रहे हैं।
Gira waterfall can be reached via jeep ride, which is available for hire, but they are only allowed to a point which is 1 kilometer away. Around the waterfall, there are a number of small stalls set up by the tribal artists who sell their traditional arts and handicrafts. One can also grab a quick bite from the eateries present near the fall. Vendors are happy with the upliftment of restrictions as now they are making a good business.
Lockdown khulne se acha hai abhi. Pehle bahut kharab tha. Lockdown mein to bandh hi tha isliye kuch dhanda bhi nahi hai.
Abhi khush ho.
Abhi khush hai.
Owing to the nature of its landmass, which is coupled up with lush green surrounding, Gujarat has an impressive collection of picturesque waterfalls that can put all your stress at bay.
Brotherhood, compassion for each other and unity, it is due to qualities like these that India stands united and unbreakable even in the most difficult of times. A similar example of brotherhood was seen in Udhampur district of Jammu and Kashmir, where people of different castes and communities gathered for the Tawi Darshan fair. Take a look.
Bounded by the thread of compassion, tolerance, brotherhood and the feeling of oneness, Dudu village in Udhampur district of Jammu and Kashmir displayed the true signs of communal harmony as the people, irrespective of their caste and religion, gathered on the banks of Tawi River for Tawi Darshan Fair. Organized by the Directorate of Tourism Jammu, the fair began with the grand ceremony of Tawi River that is hailed as the heavenly daughter of the sun god. Though the fair included only the Hindu rituals, people from all communities eagerly participated in it, setting a beautiful example of peace and brotherhood.
अभी जो हमने जो कार्यक्रम हमारा था वो तवी दर्शन का, तवी नदी के लिए था। पानी का कोई धर्म नहीं होता है, वो सब तवी नदी सूर्यपुत्री वो सभी का प्यास बुझाएगी। तो ये बहुत ही अच्छी संस्कृति है यहाँ की कि सारे लोग मिलजुल के रहते हैं और यहाँ के लोगों का प्रयास है और हमारा भी प्रयास है ये ऐसी चीज़ें आगे होती रहें और संस्कृति क्या समग्र होती है, सारे लोग एक दूसरे से जुड़े होते हैं। तो ये कार्यक्रम ऐसे ही आगे चलता रहे और ये संदेश देश में प्रदेश में फैले कि सारे लोग एक साथ एक जैसे एक होके रह सकते हैं।
Apart from religious ceremonies, various cultural events were also organized at this fair, which is rejoiced by people of all faiths. Applauding this step of tourism department, people, regardless of their religion, attended the event and said that this move will boost the tourism in the region following the development of the village.
यहाँ मैं हिंदू मुसलमान सिख सब यकसां रहते हैं इधर हर एक आदमी की अपनी बरादरी है हर एक आदमी अपनी बरादरी के साथ रहता है हमारा आना जाना यहाँ हिंदू का घर में हिंदू का मुसलमान घर में ये इकट्ठे चलते हैं
The Tawi River, which finds a conspicuous and reverent mention in the Indian ancient scriptures, is a symbol of humanity and peaceful coexistence of people in Jammu and Kashmir. Such steps taken by the government will not only reinforce people's belief in the secular fabric of the country, but will also help in preserve the natural beauty and cleanliness of the river.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A paper mache artist based in India's northern Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir has painted the old map of the city, reminding people of the beauty and changes that the city has witnessed over the years. Makbul Jan, a renowned artist in Kashmir, has been working for more than 2 decades on preserving and cultivating different local art forms like fabric painting, papier-mâché, pottery and many more.
ये मेरा ख्याल आ गया कश्मीर नए पे जो सिटी का मैंने ये एक बुक पे देखा फिर मैंने सोचा मैं क्यों नहीं मैं कब्रे के ऊपर बनाऊँ पर कब्रे के ऊपर मैं कर रहा था काम मुझे 20 साल हो गए कब्रे के ऊपर मैं कश्मीर हैंडीक्राफ्ट से फिर रजिस्ट्रेशन भी की कश्मीर फैब्रिक पेंटिंग ये अलग सा आर्ट था यहाँ कोई नहीं करता था ये
यूजिंग अ 5x7 feet फैब्रिक जान अटेम्प्टेड टू शो द लॉस्ट ब्यूटी ऑफ द ओल्ड सिटी including the iconic Dal Lake, Jhelum River and other tourist attractions to remind the young generation of the importance of preserving the culture, tradition of Kashmir and conserving the environment. Jan, who has been working on the map for the past year, says he wants the map to be preserved in the Indian Parliament.
जब आर्टिसन कोई चीज बनाता है ये किस लिए बनाता है जब टूरिस्ट यहाँ आ जाएगा ये खरीदेगा जब टूरिस्ट यहाँ नहीं आ जाएगा आर्टिसन का बेकार है यहाँ जब मार्केट ही ख़त्म हो जाएगा यही मैं याद दिला रहा हूँ कश्मीर जाहिलियम क्या था ये क्या था ये इसलिए मैंने ये सोचा ये मैं बनाऊँगा नया सरी उनको याद दिलाऊँगा
The art of the papier mache was highly favored by Mughal emperors of the 15th and 16th centuries. The unique craft involves the use of paper pulp to create artifacts painted by expert craftsmen with lifelike images of kingfishers, maple leaves and other motifs. Indian badminton player PV Sindhu won a bronze medal at the Tokyo Olympics a day after losing the crucial game for the top spot, leaving her family ecstatic back home.
I told her, you have given your best and no problem, but concentrate today. And just think that you are giving me a gift and play on the court. So I'm very happy.
Very happy. Sindhu won the medal today. She played very well. Extremely happy. Because we missed the goal, but this is also equivalent. Medal is medal.
Sindhu defeated China's He Bingjiao 21-13, 21-15 in badminton women's singles in the process of becoming the first Indian woman to win 2 individual medals at the Olympics and the 4th woman in the world to win a medal in 2 consecutive Olympics. Sindhu had lost a crucial game to Chinese Taipei's Tai Zhu Wing. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi congratulated her on Twitter on her win. Tourist influx increased in Kargil Dras region of northern India near Pakistan and China border after relaxation in COVID-19 curbs.
इसमें दराज वालों का बहुत एडवांटेज है सर और जो होटल्स है दराज में
वो सब बहुत बढ़िया होटल्स बना हुआ है, तो सब टूरिस्ट यहाँ से स्टे करके सोनमार्ग से आगे यहाँ पे स्टे करके फिर आगे कारगिल की तरफ निकल जाते हैं वो लोग।
तो इससे कितना डेवलपमेंट होता है?
इससे डेवलपमेंट तो बहुत ज़्यादा होगा सर, काफ़ी होगा, क्योंकि टूरिस्ट अभी बहुत बढ़ रहा है, एकदम कोविड ख़त्म होने की वजह से फिर बहुत ज़्यादा टूरिस्ट आ रहा है, तो अभी कुछ बढ़िया हो रहा है सर एडवांटेज।
Kargil in Ladakh territory is one of the most visited tourist destinations for adventure lovers who ride motorcycles in the Himalayan hills.
यहाँ पर मैं second time आया हूँ, ये बहुत ही ज़्यादा beautiful place है। जैसे अभी तो हम transit Ladakh से होके श्रीनगर जा रहे हैं, यहाँ का हर एक शहर, हर एक कस्बा, हर एक गांव एक खुद की अलग ही beauty बनाए रखे हैं।
However, tourism was on halt in the region owing to coronavirus restrictions. After easing of the curbs, tourists are approaching the region once again.
India is a country where different communities reside in peace and harmony. Example of this harmonious existence could be seen in all parts of the country by certain acts of kindness performed by individuals and organizations. A similar example of kindness was recently seen in a small town in Karnataka where a Muslim man marries off a Hindu girl.
Mehboob Masli is a resident of Vijayapura town in Karnataka. Respected and known for his social work all around his town, Masli's recent act of kindness has made him the apple of everyone's eye. Despite of being a Muslim, Masli married off an orphan Hindu girl, Pooja, to a Hindu groom in accordance with Hindu traditions.
ಆ ಶೋಧನೆಗೆ ಬಂದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಂದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಹುಡುಗ ಅದ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಅಂದ ಆ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋದ ನಂತರ ಆ ಮನೆ ಪದ್ಧತಿ ಆ ಹುಡುಗ ಎರಡು ಜಾತಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಆದ ನಂತರ ಎರಡು ಜಾತಿ ಕೂಡಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಮಗಳು ಸಾಕೀನಿ ಅದು ಪರದೇಶಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಉಡಿಯೊಳಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ ನೀವು ಸಾಕಿ ಅಂತ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾನು ರಿಕ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡೆ ತದನಂತರ ಅವ್ರು ಏನು ಹೇಳೋದು ನೀವೊಬ್ಬ ಮುಸಲ್ಮಾನರು ಒಂದು ಹಿಂದೂ ಹುಡುಗಿಗೆ ಭಾಳ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಒಂದು ಬಳಕ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸಾಕೀರಿ ಸಲಿಯೂರಿ ಅಂದ ಬಳಕ ನಮಗೊಂದು ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಡಬೇಡ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಏನದ ನಮಗೆ ಕನ್ಯಾ ಕೊಡ್ರಿ ಕಾಯಿ ಕನ್ಯಾ ಕೊಡ್ರಿ ನಾವು ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀವಿ ಅಂತಂದರು
Pooja is an 18-year-old girl who was orphaned a decade ago. It is since then that Masli has been taking care of Pooja as a father after her own relatives refused to bring her up. Though Masli is a father of two daughters and two sons, Masli not only took care of Pooja's well-being and education, but also took the responsibility of marrying her off with a man from the religion she belongs to. Masli made sure that the rituals of marriage are performed according to Vedic traditions.
Magalikitta hechigi sa sakidda nanu tandu nanna mani olaga gurugalige karisi swamigalige karisi vidhi vidhanagante paddhati prakara akshata karanavannu nanu rachotti swamigalu visveshwara devalayada obba swamigalannu karisi matta nanna hiteshigalada irukasi muttiyavar balli ಅವರ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ನಾನು ಸಲಹೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಒಂದು ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ
ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ನೆಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದೀಸ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯುಮ್ಯಾನಿಟಿ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅಬವ್ ಆಲ್ ರಿಲಿಜನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ಸ್
ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರಾಫ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕುಜೀನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ರಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೀಜನ್ಸ್ ಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಟೈಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸಿಟಿಜನ್ಸ್ Regular organizations of exhibition plays a significant role in showcasing the art and culture of a region. Recently, an exhibition was organized in Srinagar city of Jammu and Kashmir, where traditional Kashmiri handicrafts and artworks were showcased.
Intricate embroidery, wooden carvings, and woven as light as air, Pashmina shawls, these are some of the features of Kashmiri handicrafts that are immensely popular all around the world. In order to showcase the beauty of Kashmiri handcrafts and handlooms, an exhibition was recently organized by the handicrafts department after the long pandemic break.
Ab jo government ne ye step utha diya hai ye bilkul acha hamare craftsmen ke liye bhi hamare local publics ke liye bhi aur hamare yahan paas mein jo government center market ke shopkeepers उनको भी इसका बेनिफिट मिलेगा जरूर मिलेगा
ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एट कश्मीर हार्ट इन श्रीनगर सिटी A large number of stalls were set up showcasing beautiful Kashmiri goods were put up at display. These stalls showcased a wide variety of artworks including wooden carvings, embroidery, papier-mâché, shawl embroidery, Kashmiri carpets and more. Artisans were happy to have been part of the exhibition as such exhibitions will be helpful in clearing their stocks which remain unsold due to the pandemic and will further promote their art form.
हमारी इन्वेंट्री आर्टिसंस की बड़ी पाइल अप हुई है तो हम अब जबकि कोविड सिचुएशन हमको थोड़ा सा अलाउ कर रही है तो उसमें हमने पहली कोशिश ये की कि यहाँ पे जो है अपने आर्टिसंस को एक प्लेटफॉर्म दे इस प्लेटफॉर्म से जो है वो अपने इन्वेंट्री को डिस्पोज ऑफ करें और ये वन आर्ट इवेंट नहीं है आने वाले दिनों में ये जो है एग्जीबिशंस चलती रहेंगी
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है क्योंकि एज एन आर्टिसन एक आर्टिस्ट को एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिल रहा है जे एंड के गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से जो हमारे यहाँ जो हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स डिपार्टमेंट है इन्होंने इनिशिएटिव लिया है कि जो हमारा वोकल फॉर लोकल कैंपेन स्टार्ट किया है बहुत अच्छी बात है यहाँ पे बहुत सारे ये आर्ट्स को स्टॉल्स को फरोख्त मिली है यहाँ पे आए हैं स्टॉल्स दिए गए हैं
इट इज़ ड्यू टू एग्जीबिशंस एंड डिस्प्लेज लाइक दीज दैट वॉट विल नॉट ओनली प्रमोट लोकल हैंडक्राफ्ट एंड इम्प्रूव लाइवलीहुड ऑफ आर्टिसंस but will also help putting Indian handcrafts on the world platform.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section World in Focus.
Coinciding with the Tokyo 2020 Olympic and Paralympic Games, the Constant Gardeners event is being organized at Ueno Onshi Park. The three-month-long event is organized by Tokyo Metropolitan Government in association with artists from United Kingdom. In this event, the artists are four robot arms, the models are Olympic athletes, and canvas is a Japanese Zen garden. Analyzing the past video footage from across a wide range of sporting disciplines and events, the Constant Gardeners communicate and celebrate the motion and physicality in professional athletes.
東京フェスティバルなんですけれども、こちらは今開催されている東京オリンピック・パラリンピックに合わせてですね、スポーツの面ばかりではなくて、文化の面でも盛り上げる、基本的にオリンピック・パラリンピックというのは、カルチュラルオリンピアードということで、文化プログラムも実際にやっていくということがある程度規定路線になっておりましてあといろんな方に、オリンピックに関わってもらいたいという趣旨で、文化プログラムをやってきてそれが東京フェスティバルという傘の中で今動いているということです
Four robotic arms work alternatively at a traditional Japanese Zen garden to draw an arc to mark the Tokyo 2020 Olympic and Paralympic schemesIn daily performances, the gardeners collaborate to create 150 unique illustrations throughout the Olympics. Japanese traditional Zen garden has attracted the people with robotic artwork during the mega sporting event.
The one thing that, as the artist and the author of this work, I was really keen for people to experience if they could come here, which is obviously more difficult now, was to create a moment of calm.A moment of reflection and a moment to meditate.
Ueno Park is one of Japan's five oldest public parks known for spectacular cherry blossoms in the spring, Ueno Zoo and many museums. Its history started in the Edo era about 400 years ago. Third general of Edo government built a big temple here and an internal political war was developed.150 years ago, it is nominated as first official park in Japan.
上野って割と歴史のあるところですから、ちょっと古いものが多いんですけれども、こういうなんか最新の技術っていうか、そういうのが飾ってある、合わさって面白いと思います。
Tokyo Olympic and Paralympic Games is being held in the wake of the Corona crisis. It expresses the direction of future path.The robotic artwork by Tokyo Metropolitan Government at a historical park sets a new pattern. Buell Zoo in central France welcomed the birth of two baby pandas early on Monday.
Female panda Huan Huan was cheered by zoo staff as there was surveillance camera footage of her giving birth and later holding her babies. Zoo head veterinarian Baptist Mulo said the cub seemed to be in good shape and said the birth was an incredible moment.
Là, c'est un super moment parce que voilà, on a deux bébés, c'était déjà le cas il y a 4 ans, mais malheureusement, il y en a un des deux qui n'a pas survécu. Et là, pour l'instant, on a deux magnifiques bébés qui sont en super état. Le premier qu'on a sorti, qu'on a pesé, le premier qui est sorti, qu'on a pesé, là, qui est en couveuse, il fait 149 grammes, donc c'est un super poids pour un bébé panda. Et le deuxième a l'air très vif dans les bras de maman, qui pour l'instant ne veut pas du tout s'en séparer et est complètement bloqué sur son bébé. Donc on va voir, je pense qu'on va attendre un tout petit peu avant de récupérer le bébé.
Huan Huan and her partner Wan Zi came to France on loan from China in 2012, and their arrival was held at the time as a sign of warning diplomatic ties between Paris and Beijing. While an adult female panda can weigh up to 125 kilograms, a baby panda weighs barely 120 grams at birth. Due to coronavirus pandemic, people are compelled to stay at home in Japan. This situation has brought in an unexpected trend. Japan's watch and electronics company Casio has launched an electric piano. It accelerates enjoyment of playing music instrument while staying at home.
この coronaka の状況で、在宅勤務プラス、こう休日もやっぱり外に出ることができなくなったところで、初めのうちは良かったんですが、だんだんと暇になってきて、でそんな時に主人がもともと趣味でギターとかをやってるので、合わせてセッションみたいな感じでできたらいいねみたいな話からちょっと電子ピアノっていうのを探し始めたのがきっかけ、長さというか音の数があって軽い、思ったよりも軽くってっていうところが決め手ですね。ピアノぐらい可愛い赤でって言っても、この赤ってなんかちょっと朱色っぽいっていうかあれなので、どんな色にも部屋の家具にも合うかなっていうところで、キーボードバージョンとかオルガンバージョンとかあるので、ちょっとそれに合わせたこう曲とか探して弾いてみたりとかしてるので、とてもちょっと飽きずに楽しんでます。
Casio analyzes that the trend of music instrument is verified according to transformation of daily life. Long-time homestaying reminds people the experience to learn or play music in the past and challenge to play it again.
このような状況の中で、自宅で過ごされる時間が増えていると思います。そんな中で鍵盤楽器というのは一人で手軽に始められる楽器でもございますので、音楽というものを気軽に楽しんでいただく、一人でも多くの方に音楽を楽しんでいただくということを基本的な事業理念にしておりまして、こちらのモデルもこうやって持ち歩きもできますので、使う時には好きなところに置いて気軽に音楽を楽しんでいただけるようなものになっております。
This piano model installs 61 kinds of music tone. It includes acoustic piano and the other music tone of electronic piano, organ and synthesizer are installed. It enables to choose favorite music tone for keyboard player. Not only keyboard function but also new developed speaker is attached. It provides clear and powerful sound despite of small size. Save space and full impact is the policy of Casio.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.